Thor is having visions of the end of Asgard. His father Odin is on his last leg. He's about to die. The goddess of death is coming to destroy everything they know and love. It's gonna take a lot to prevent these visions from happening, but the biggest problem is Thor is in jail. He's a slave. He ain't even home. This movie is outrageously funny from start to finish. The opening sequence is fire, literally. The action to laugh ratio feels like Guardians of the Galaxy. I would actually say that this has more laughs and more action than Guardians of the Galaxy. I felt like I was either laughing or being amazed, or laughing and being amazed simultaneously throughout the movie.
Whoa.
Whoa. It's really fast paced and hardly has any downtime. It's fun in every sense of the word. Flat out, this movie has some awesome action scenes. Many of them and their mechanics felt like the God of War video game. They were so fluid. The moves felt intentional and authentic to each character. The Thor and Hulk fight was everything I wanted and dreamed of.
You can look at Thor as like Thor reloaded. With the previous two Thor movies, we knew Thor was special. We knew Thor was strong. Now Thor is out there doing more than what I ever expected for a Thor movie in the Marvel Universe. And another thing that was cool that they did, that I noticed, I don't know if it was by coincidence, but I played Marvel vs. Capcom, and one of the moves, the Mighty Strike, they threw that in the movie. It's real quick, you can miss it, but it's in the movie. He's doing that move. And I think that's something cool. People like me, gamers like me, and fans of the Marvel comics will like.
And I have to say, Thor and Hulk's relationship is hilarious. The dynamic between Thor and Hulk and Thor and Loki is very bromantic. It felt very 21 Jump Street, Superbad, Lethal Weapon. Aesthetically, this thing is an eye pleaser. Marvel has done well by itself by continuing to expand the crayon box on screen. Asgard is back in all of its elegance. And the planet that Thor is imprisoned on is littered with an array of punchy pigments. The CGI is amazing. This is what Norse mythology in a comic book should look like. You already know what to expect from Thor and Hulk on the acting tip. Tessa Thompson is great as Valkyrie. This felt like the role that she's been prepping for all of her life. There's an absolutely beautiful scene with Valkyrie in this movie. It's one of my favorite moments in the film. I won't spoil it. This scene by itself made me want to see a standalone Valkyrie film. Cate Blanchett as the goddess of death is the closer. Her character, Hela, to quote Den of Geeks, is a force of nature. Her costume gave me old school Disney times 2017 vibe. She has this really cool move to reveal her helmet. It looks like she's swiping up to close a cell phone app. It's dope. It's fire. After watching this movie, I felt like Tessa Thompson and Cate Blanchett go home and they actually are these people. Although I probably missed some of the subtext of what Hela actually means to this story.
The thing is, Hela represents the ugly side of what it takes to build a great nation. And a lot of times, like with America, America likes to gloss over and glamorize and damn near rewrite how we got here. And Hela is a great metaphor for that, because like when she walks in the Great Hall the first time she gets to Asgard and she throws the knives in the ceiling and brings down that mural, and you see what was really, what the real history of Asgard was. It was like, oh, you really did have to like slaughter some people to get there. And that's something that people don't understand when it comes to conquering a land or creating a great nation. Sometimes that has to happen. And America, like much like Odin, likes to forget that past. And I think the reason why he cast Hela out, yeah, she probably got too big for her britches, but also too, she was a reminder of what he really was. Because that's who he really is. A conqueror is always going to be a conqueror.
I actually have nothing bad to say about this movie. Marvel shows us yet again why it's the best in the business when it comes to creating superhero films. They follow what many great coaches in sports call the KISS method, or keep it simple, stupid. Thor's desire, or dramatic goal as John Truby calls it, is simply to prevent his home from being destroyed. However, along the way, there's so many moments where this movie enjoys itself, where it surprises you, where it wows you, where it isn't afraid to laugh at itself. It isn't afraid to be self-aware. You can tell that everyone on set had a good time making this film, and it shows. Thor Ragnarok is action-packed with tons of laughs. The runtime is 2 hours, but it felt like an hour and 30. It's worth going to see more than once. I'm giving Thor Ragnarok a 9 out of 10. What did you think about Thor Ragnarok? Let me know, comment below. If you like this video, like and share this video. And I can't forget to mention our sponsors for this review. Shout out to the good folks over at The Working Class. If you enjoy a plethora of topics that range from health and wellness to pop culture, find The Working Class wherever you listen to podcasts. If you like supernatural stories about vampires and political upheaval, hit the link in the description section to find more on the Immortal series by Valjean Jeffers. If you would like to promote your product, your website, your social media sites, your platform, or the future review, come holla at me. If you would like to help me make more videos, pledge $1, whatever you feel, to my Patreon page. This keeps me out of the Hunger Games and in front of your face. We got more movie reviews coming your way, and we got more book reviews coming your way, and we got more of that random.
And we got more of that random stuff coming your way.
Okay. I'm in the bathroom!